7 o'clock, we have, we'll call a meeting to order on behalf of the board. I'd like to welcome each and every one here tonight, and all of our central office staff that are here tonight, and visitors, and maybe. If you could, let's stand, say the pledge, or remain standing for a moment, silence, please.
The allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please say it, please. The part of the party is just trying to come back, like, I'm not really saying we're good yet. Next time, we'll be again to the election of officers in September, so we need to do that again, so we'll try to open Dr. Cole.
All right, I guess I'm gonna open up the floor for nominations for, Chair. Do I have any nominations?
I made my vote.
Yes, sir.
All right. Got a first and a second. We want to go ahead, so it's out there, all those in favor of, Mr. Burleson being reinstated as Chair, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Awesome.
I thank each and every one of you, and, I enjoy doing it, and, it is what it is. I work hard with Dr. Cole when he meets me, I'm y'all's voice, and if y'all need me, call me, or text me, or email me, or whatever, anytime. And, we've got a great board to work with, and a great superintendent and staff, one of the best I've ever seen. All my time, that's for, been very honest with you. Thank you again, all of you, for your comments. Next is the election of Vice Chairman. Do we have any nominations for the Vice Chairman?
I'm on the Farrell, but.
Second.
Have, Mr. Jordan nominates Mr. Farrell, and Mr. Benson seconds, or any other nominations. All those in favor of Mr. Farrell being elected Vice Chairman, please say aye.
Aye.
And those opposed, no, motion passed. The next officer we have is a TLN representative. Mr. Benson, have you been doing that?
Couple years ago, Mr. Clark.
This one, okay.
Really?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Who?
Okay. Do we have a nomination, anybody have a nomination for TLN representative?
I nominate Mr. Asley.
I'll second that.
Any other nominations? We have a nomination for Mr. Clark, seconded by Mr. Benson, for Mr. Asley Davis, and for the TLN representative. I feel like we're better guy than that, so.
I couldn't.
All of them, they let me know by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, no, motion passed. Congratulations, Mr. Davis.
Now, if you look at that love pass last year.
You can, one day you don't want to, ladies and network. Are there any additions? Do we have a motion to approve the agenda as presented?
Come on.
Motion by Mr. Davis. Seconded by Ms. McCarthy. All those in favor of letting me know by saying aye.
Aye.
And those opposed, no, motion passed. Are there any additions to the agenda, or any personal additions here on the scene? Okay. Next item is the consent agenda. Does anybody wish to remove any items, so that it might be discussed, If not, do we have a motion to approve?
Make that motion.
Motion by Mr. Clark, and seconded by Mr. Jordan. All those in favor of letting me know by saying aye.
Aye.
And those opposed, no, motion passed. Get on to our report, direct instruction report, Dr. Burke.
Just a few things from the Sheriff's Department. First of all, our teaching family college in Rio Grande will be September 19th, 5:30 to 7:30 at Wright High School, so if you'd like to join us, we'd love to do that. Also, just a note of congratulations, the art teacher, Dr. Gardens Elementary, Ms. Triplett, has been awarded the 2020 First Year Teacher of the Year and will be recognized at the Tennessee Arts Education Association Fall Conference in October. So we certainly say congratulations to her, appreciate all her hard work.
What was her name again, Matt?
Ms. Triplett, T-R-I-P-L-E-T-T.
Where she teach?
Gardens, our teacher.
And what was that award again, I'm sorry?
That's about 2020 First Year Teacher of the Year.
Great.
And that's through the Tennessee Arts Education Association. So we have, we are here to our aspiring administrator academy, so just want to let you know a little bit about that. We met in our first meeting on September 5th. We do four meetings a year, so we'll have two in the fall, two in the spring. Our first one was last week on the 5th, had 43 teachers there who are aspiring to be administrators. So we were excited to see that. Our topic was tips from a rookie, and Ms. Latoya Avery, Mr. Marty Price, and then Dr. Chris Morris spoke to the group about lessons that they learned in their first year as administrators, and they did a good job of that. Our next meeting will be in October, we'll be talking about discipline, so we look forward to that. Then the last thing I have in your packets, Mary and Sandy will give you some information on test data for the spring. As you know, it's very exciting to be one of 20 districts in state Tennessee designated as exemplary, and certainly want to say fine that our teachers and staff have done an amazing job. We just appreciate all their hard work to make sure our students are successful, and of course, thanks to you all as board members for your support as well. Had really good results, we're very excited about that, and looking forward to another great year this year in instruction. That's all I have, unless someone has questions.
Thank you, Dr. Wilson. Where cooperation between Dr. Fisher?
I'm gonna do my time tonight to Mr. Henry Glass, who has some information he would like to share with you.
Dr. Fisher. So we need to short this way, so get out of here early, go eat something. I just wanted to come forward to you guys tonight and appreciate the teachers for y'all. We are in need of purchasing quite a bit of equipment here, a lot of equipment that we have. Was purchased in 1982, and we got to use that over 7 years, I know, and I think it's pretty well up as far as we go. And the problem that I'm having is with our dishwashers. I have five dishwashers that were purchased in there again. And a certain part goes out of them, can't even find it, can call home bars and lap that. Don't even have one books anymore. And what I would like to do, send it to you in your packet. We replaced one of the high school's dishwasher last year, called the circuit board went out. And what I need to do, I have four more in the system. I have Dunn's Elementary, Bryan Elementary, Cressy Elementary, and Buckley Elementary. And in my plan that I have, if you would like to look at 2019 and 2020, that is in the packet, you'll see the list of items that I'd like to purchase this year. Yeah, it's 2018, board on top. And the second sheet is a narrative about what I would like to purchase. And the third page actually has a 2-year plan of what I would like to purchase this year and also next year. And I've already talked to vendors. These are pretty close estimated costs for the division 1920 at $185,000. And in 2021, I would like to purchase two more dishwashers for the ones that are outdated and can be parts for Cressy Elementary and Buckley Elementary. And one of the biggies that I want to do. Yeah, Buckley High School is the second largest school in the county. They have probably the smallest freezer space of anybody in the county. I went by and got some measures for the schools, and Buckley High
Fraser, nine foot five inches wide and 7 foot 4 inches deep. And I've got some other ones that are 29 feet wide, 11 feet deep, but they have no limit. And we had to purchase a two-door freezer, a white freezer, about 5 years ago, to have enough space to store all those knives. And we're having to be very creative because against the health regulations to store any moving food on the floor. So we had to get crates or whatever to keep it on the floor. But we're gonna have to build, we want to build it where it's attached to the kitchen. Don't have to walk outside. We have to build a dock or a concrete slab raised up where the ladies can come right outside and walk straight into the freezer and have storage space just like everybody else. And so that's kind of what I'm looking at for this year. Now, in our financial report that you have, if you look on line 11 of the financial report, this is as of 2018-19 school year. We have $3.7 million in our fund balance for cafeteria funds. So I would like to be able to get $185,000 of that, or get you guys to go, hopefully make a recommendation, I'll approve it. I know there's protocol that you have to go through in order to ascertain this money. But I'm coming to you to ask for that, and it's just time to get you real quick to make it safe, more efficient, energy-wise. Also, for the staff to be able to cook the food and store the food line.
Mr. Henry, are you asking also for the 2020-21?
I would like to ask for that for 2021. Yes, I would. And then I'd have $90,000, so it'd be about $275,000 of the fund balance. And hopefully I will have to come back next year and ask for more, but I would upgrade that.
Just one time?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's, and.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
It's a single year, so you can, whatever money you have in there, we'll roll back in.
Okay, great.
So, I mean, maybe it'd be appropriate for us to ask them to again do it for next year, and then we'll present that when we do the new budget, but it's just a one-year budget. So whatever.
Do it all this year, right?
Whatever you can do this year, because it's just like on the roof.
Right.
What we can't do this year goes back to them, so there's no reason to get next year, unless you can take care of all of it this year.
It's gonna really be pushing it, because time to do the bidding, like after the bids, we have each prices, then it takes 6 days to get the equipment.
That's what I asked. So now, we're just asking for the 19-year-old.
Yes.
Right.
Okay. What I'm asking for is.
Do these come with a 37-year warranty?
It's kind of like an HVAC, you know, put it over here and talk to God and start it. I remember Dad had one at 30-something years old, and I talked to God and saw one night, and I said, how many years on it? He said, we'll get one of the rest. He said, no, you make a guy with a parts people out there or something, or something fall. So that's what I'm asking.
I'll make a motion that we approve the equipment purchase for the service department.
Second.
I have a motion by Mr. Benson, second by Mr. Chief. Anybody have any other questions, anybody? All those in favor, let me know by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, no. Motion carries. Now, thank you, Mr. Glass.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, Dr. Chief. Mr. Glenn Carter.
think a lot of little people think that. Anyway, you know, and the mayor's more important now, so I appreciate it, and so, their officer was far, I would probably shoot October 1st, or maybe sometime around there, so I don't know, but. I'm gonna talk to the police chief, you walk in, try to get in that situation, so I look forward to speaking with them. Maybe their mayor board all down, come forward, we can work something out with them as well. Still talking with the, commissioner, chair, department, hopefully, we'll have security, still going on with the call, and maybe as well, and not just, they try anything? Any questions for this department?
Mr. Carter, we appreciate you attending those meetings and getting this IRS all up, Jeff. I know we've been there for the years, and I learned to do it very fast.
We all are.
I appreciate that.
Yes, we are too, our goal is to get one in every school, and, I hope you do that before I pay.
Hopefully, yes.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Carter.
The state board, financial board.
Yes, the first thing, I think I should talk to you all about, the Brighton Utility District and how, we have underpaid according to their meters, and the agreement has come to, we owe them $5,408.29. They requested us to pay it in three different installments, starting in October, so I know you all knew about that, but that's the final number that we have to pay.
I think the department are meters.
I wish I could pay you, Mr. Carter, we.
Let me say this, so y'all know since last year, I've been working with the city, trying to straighten, we, I spoke with their attorney, he's our attorney as well, and I'm coming back and forth with them on this, and basically, the agreement was, we will agree to pay this, but we won't be agreeing to pay anything else due to the misreading of those meters, because it wasn't, an error in the meters, it was a misreading of the meters. So that was our.
So, they don't read them, I think that's the thing, they estimate, and so they let the estimation go for so long, that they're like, oh man, it's terrible.
So they, so that was, you know, the agreement that I worked through with them, was to say, look, we'll take care of this, but we don't want any more, surprises, which basically.
We do, it's my, I'm not there.
Absolutely, but apparently they have some new equipment now, and have changed some things, it's in the agreement with the attorney, and that's, better.
Yes, sir. If I may, I was at their meeting the other night for 2 hours. They have new meters, they have new smart meters, I'm gonna use the word smart meters, all throughout the town, right, and to be fair to them, they have overcharged us, and they came back and looked at it at some times, and then adjusted our bill down, so. They're trying to do right there, Mr. David Brayton from Poplar Grove, they're working with them the last year, year and a half, and, trying to get everything situated. I think they're on the way, they do have new meters, but, makes it a lot easier to get the correct, usage.
We're down to paying, so $2,408.
And they just didn't get any meter part?
All right, if you're ready for the financial report, let's look at, Fund 141. Our revenue for, the month of August was $6,533,833.88, or 7.8% of our revenue. The total for the 2 months that we've had so far is $7,070,995. The difference between last year and this year is very minimal, so we're pretty much on target with where we were before. Our expenditures for the month of August, $4,323,496, which is 5.1% of our budget, and we have spent, 8% of our budget, we have received 8.4, so we're, cash flow. But at the end of the year, as you can tell from his fund balance, he has money, but it's just very slow in the time. They spent $400,336 and 26 cents. What they spent in 2 months of school, 8.4% of their budget. Questions on tax rate? All right, for the 177 capital project, supposedly received no money, and he spent in the month of August, $639,080 and 27 cents. So that's 34.7% of the budget that we have left in there. And we spent $890,932, almost half of what we had in there. We pay the majority of our roofing, but not all. So there's still something black behind the scenes. Architectural bills as well. Any questions on the financial report? All right, if you look at the amendments that you have, we have to take care of the safety grants, the money that you approved the last time. Put page numbers on it so it might help us where we are. So we're on page two, and we added into the revenue line $46,590,231,400. To increase that line to $571,400. You can just follow that down, all those numbers are exactly the same, just following it through the process. And then if you turn the page over.
That's the entire grant?
Well, it's not actually, I'm going to tell you where all it is. It's not the full grant because we're not 100% sure that we can utilize the rest. So we only put $105,000 in for the school resource officers. So we'll have to come back, but I hate to put it, or we decided not to put it in there until we were certain it was going to be there. And then we can spend it. So if you look on page five, the $141,000 that's going into 309, that is for security as well as school resource officers. That's $105,000, and then $36,000, that's for security that's coming out of that budget as well. So we now have $295,000 in that line item. Then on that same column, on other equipment, that $90,400 that has been added, those are leftover money from the last year's grant, the carryover money, as well as $88,000 from the new safety grant that Mr. Turner had. So we increased that budget expenditure line by $231,400 as well. Taking in and spending. Questions on that? All right, that's all there is in the 141. I think you can spend all that paperwork, but. So we have come up with a total on page 10. Our total budget is $84,237,400. Questions on 141? And that, approval of that amendment?
Do we have a motion to approve the financial report that we did have this, this grant? Motion by Mr. Terrell, second by Mr. Tyson. All those in favor? All those in favor, let it be known by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, motion carries.
Okay, and now we'll do the 142 budget, and as you can see, it's quite lengthy. And I will just tell you, all of these dollars are $3, and so they've just been re-spent. It's like you're bringing in a brand new budget of $1,189,119.61 that has just been approved. Title I carryover money is included in this, as well as the gone down to other student support in category 72130. In the other wages and salaries, and these are minute changes, but it's all because a different person is represented in that grant. So they had to adjust the salaries and the benefits. They added those little pieces, from 189 down to 212. All of those are salaries and benefits. And they just had to tweak the people that were in there. And then they added, other materials and supplies, $1,500. And other charges, $240,890 in the other student support. And that's, mostly psychology, teachings that are in that student support. And then at the supervisory instructional program in the 72210, at the bottom of page 241.42. The adjustments have been made for the salaries and benefits. You can see all of those things that they have moved around. They added $3,000 to other contracted services. And they, added $147.94 to other supplies. $322,800 for staff and service. And $2,470 for other equipment. So they, added $315,894 to the regular instruction program, but it's not, it's the supervisory fees. On the next page, in the vocational fees, I think we talked, Dr. Bird told you all last time that, we got a grant for certifications at TCAT. Well, here's the money that we received when that grant was approved, $14,245. And, they have some things in place to take advantage of those, certifications. At the bottom of page 3, they added all of the monies for the succeed grant, $354,234. And it is divided among teachers, and other salaries and wages. And then, of course, social security, retirement, all the benefits that have to be paid. And then on other contracted services, they have $13,000 for, contracted services, $7,135 for instructional supplies, $500 for other supplies, $4,050 for in-service, and $21,000 for other charges, for a total of $384,234. And then with all those changes, we added $18,746 to, indirect costs, which will come back to the 141 budget at the end of the year if it stays that way. Any questions about 142?
Do we have a motion to approve the, 142?
My last thing is to, I guess, ask you if, Dr. Holmes sent you guys an email yesterday about a possible bonus, for the exemplary status that we earned in the district. And the numbers that I have for you to think about, we had 800 certified, staff, and if that bonus is $500, that would be $400,000, and all of this would have to come from fund balance. And then we have 389 classified people in the buildings. Food service, we have 94, and possibly a few more. We're going to count those again. It's a moving target. We have people that come and go all the time.
thinking about. Row one, one, one part of it.
Just in general, just getting everybody, you know, we have six schools opposite of Row One and Four Exemplary, right? So we know that, but the exemplary status is a culmination of data from all the schools everybody put into that hat. It's not just from those schools, it's from all across the district, right? And so we were trying to make determination number one, from one of 20 school districts out of 145, their exemplary that's permitted. So we thought, it would be not only a good reward, but a good incentive for everyone to, help us remain an exemplary system. Because we, you know, we need basically all hands on deck, and it's, that was the thinking behind it. But, I mean, it's good work, absolutely.
Well, I think either way is good, Dr. Todd. If the new people get this money, it would motivate them, you know, I'd like to have it again next year, maybe. Even though it's come up down.
$43,000.
Right. Here's the thought that I have, so if my, I think it's not a Scrooge thing. But you have a lot of people all across the county that work real hard, including this office staff, to get this to rare status. And is it diminishing what they did to get it to someone that wasn't part of that?
You what?
But that's what we have with the records.
The director brought it up. Absolutely, I understand the point. You know, for me, and I understand exactly, there will be some feel that way. And I do lean more toward the incentive piece for those 40 something. You know, I mean, they're a part of an exemplary system. This is a great system.
I was questioning.
Right, absolutely.
Questioning the decision.
That's a good question.
You know, I remember back in the day when I was teaching at Bright Middle School, it was the year I retired, I think, 2011. I think something good happened. We got a bonus, right?
You didn't get it.
I didn't get it. Because I didn't fire, so I'm still holding it.
Really, what I'm working for here is to extend this thing another year for our folks.
But my thought also was, remember we talked, when we were talking about our five-year plan, we talked about new teachers coming in and how we can encourage those folks to maintain. So I'm thinking, the teacher says, well, these people value their teachers, you know, they'll pretty cool.
Yeah, so teacher bonus.
Right.
And that's the incentive piece to me, is, you know, that we want to show people that we do appreciate, you know, hard work.
The thing about that is, it has to be a unit. So, you wake up one day and there's $504 in your account, and it's really said, you're going to miss the effect that you want to have.
Absolutely, and that's honestly why we're asking so early, because it's something that we want to get out, like in November, so folks will have it prior to, you know, Christmas holiday and all that, and it'll be something that's.
Ms. Davis, you don't love me, it's going to be a separate check.
Separate checks.
Love me, aren't you?
And that might sound crazy, but you can put a thank you note.
I understand.
I don't know what you're talking about, because in the day when you did do checks, you guys delivered them to the.
Right.
You don't do checks.
No, you don't do that. I shouldn't say anything, but I'm curious.
I do think it plays into our strategic plan, the incentive piece, I do think it plays into that. But, you know, we definitely, you know, it's so hard, I just came back from that conference, the superintendent's conference, and that was one of the big topics of discussion, was how hard it is across the state to find qualified licensed teachers for the openings that we have. I mean, everybody's struggling with it. And, you know, incentivizing and having ways to draw those folks in here is just a plus as far as I'm concerned. We're already competing with, you know, the municipalities and some of the other areas that are able to.
That are exemplary and money too.
For the learning, that's right. That's right.
Well, I did mention that, this would not include the, part-time employees. What group makes up the largest?
The part-time, yes, and we classify, we have 720-day contract people, and we do not include them, because they're both part-time. And those were certified, so we didn't count them. And then, if the biggest part of the, we didn't do SACC, because they only work a couple hours a day. We didn't do the, we didn't count the people who are 25-hour people, that they just go 5 hours a day, 2 days a week. We didn't do attendance, we didn't do bus attendance. There's a bulk of them. I think we ended up in our draw from the report, we had 660-some-odd people, and we ended up with 389.
We didn't do the attendance, but.
I don't mean attendance, I mean attendance.
I got.
We ride the bus, you know. And I, you know, I can look at that any way you all want to, wherever your pleasure is, what we'll do, but we didn't do part-time because we don't work it.
I make a motion to approve what you submit.
Second by Mr. Schuster, second by Mr. Hess, is there any further discussion?
Wait, could we include in there an amendment of initial $400 for that employee back to $2,000?
I'd like to consider it, probably, because if you, you say it's something.
They are giving something, they give it off.
That's what I'm saying.
Well, we've got a motion.
We got a motion on the floor, right there. You're talking about Lauren, was Lauren was speaking about giving them two seats instead of five, that's why I should say.
That's right.
But I want to address that before we go into that motion, you know, that's what I was.
Yeah, I can then to the.
We got a motion on the floor, so we're gonna have to, is any order before the motion? Okay. That was before the motion, what was the?
That's my question, before the vote.
Well, that's, we have a motion on the floor, we do it, and then, just pass it. All those in favor of the motion, as presented by Ms. Page, the information given to us on this page, let me know by say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, no. So the motion did pass.
What was that total again?
$528,750, but I think we're going to ask $450, just to make sure that we're covered.
That's covered, certified and not certified.
Yeah.
Mr. Burdo.
I would like to make an amendment to that motion, that we change that to half or full.
Well, that we have for classified as well.
That's an amendment to the teachers.
At least the teachers, for sure.
Hang on, what's the motion, you passed, it's passed. You amended before it's voted, right? So you can amend it now, it's gonna pass.
I'll withdraw that, I'm gonna say, go ahead.
And I'm sorry, man.
You know, that's a good question, I was at Walgreens today, but all they asked me was, do you want to contribute to education?
Yeah.
Right, and that's all they told me, and I asked specifically what education you're talking about, and the lady there at the time couldn't give you an answer, so that's interesting. That's good to hear, which, were you the one where?
Right.
The only thing that I could say would be the Tiffin County Education Foundation possibly, we can check. I don't know.
I
Clay, do you have anything else?
No, sir.
Thank you for your time, support. Dr. Thomas, you have anything else?
I do want to say that, I appreciate, all the discussion, thank you, all the great points, I do appreciate that. I do want to address, Mr. Clark said something about, communication, and definitely need to do that, need to let them, you know, let them know how much we appreciate all that, and talk to them, just kind of, you know, kind of roll that out, so to speak, right? So they know what this is for, these members' status, that's not something that's just, that everybody needs to enjoy, thank you, that kind of deal, so I absolutely agree with something here. Where we communicate, once we're able to talk to, county division, go to the next step, and. Absolutely.
All right, good point.
TSBA convention deadline is August 11th, today, if I have, I guess my people do all.
I think that's.
Oh, we got it, fine.
Okay, no.
All right, all good, May is September the 23rd, that's on Monday at Barfield Elementary School, 3368 South Barfield Island Road.
Say that, Chris.
It's a 3368 South Barfield Road. Barfield Island Road. And, it starts at 5, which would be, it says 7:45, we need to have it early, so.
John, will you have Dr. Berg or Dan that today?
Sure, she's. Jackson wants to grab a bus, she says. Don't run, geez. On my way to birthday is.
I got one. So, me at the month football game, it's time to bring them out, they won't try to put hand ribbons from down the steps, now a lot of people can't get them down the steps, and I had several people with fogging up, and I had a few at college talking about, saying that the board meeting, she can like to do something, some, work out some kind of hand ribbon, you can't put them solid, but you have to put them, maybe two or three steps, and leave them one out with it, but we had set a lot of people to get them down the steps.
Do you need that, Dr. Fisher, oh, so that's something that I can talk to Mr. Donnie about, you know, we're in the midst of finishing up that capital improvement plan, that four-year plan, and that's something, you know, we're gonna be working on that somewhere, absolutely. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, we will.
Ms. Robert?
Ms. Carter, and I will send Fisher, but I want to say thank you to everybody that called, prayed, and checked on my husband, and I said, through his illness, which was a long bout, and to his past. But I just want to officially say thank you to all of you, you've been great, you've been wonderful, and you've done something to, those people here. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Robert. You still in our prayers, it's nice to have you. If no one else had anything else, we'll have a motion to the front.